Welcome to Relaxing Boutique Channel. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Mystery of Prague. Chapter 1. The Cryptic Clock. In Prague, a city where every cobblestone whispers tales from the past, Lukas, a young and passionate researcher of medieval history, found himself entranced by the city's heart and soul, the astronomical clock. Standing in the old town square, with its vibrant amalgam of tourists, locals, and the chiming of the hour, Lukas's gaze was fixed on the intricate clock, a masterpiece of timekeeping artistry. Lukas, with his tousled brown hair and keen hazel eyes, had always been drawn to the mysteries of the past. His fascination with Prague's history was not just academic, it was a personal quest to understand the city's legacy of mysticism and science. The astronomical clock, or the horloge, as it was locally known, was a symbol of this legacy. Built in the 15th century, it was a marvel of engineering, its dials and mechanisms offering not just the time but a representation of the celestial movements. One autumn afternoon, while examining the details of the horloge, Lukas noticed something peculiar. Among the zodiac signs, saints, and animated figures, he spotted a series of symbols that seemed deliberately placed yet out of sync with the clock's astronomical theme. These symbols, small and almost imperceptible, formed a pattern that hinted at a deliberate design. Intrigued, Lukas began to document these symbols, sketching them in his notebook. He spent days observing the clock, noting how the symbols interacted with the movement of the clock's hands and the astronomical dial. His curiosity turned into an obsession as he realized that these symbols might form a code, a hidden message embedded in the clock by its creators. Lukas's research led him to the city's archives, where he delved into the history of the horloge. He learned about the clockmaker, Master Hanus, and the legend surrounding the clock's creation. One legend spoke of a secret so profound that it had to be hidden in plain sight, accessible only to those who could decipher its code. The more Lukas learned, the more he became convinced that the code was linked to Prague's rich alchemical past. The city had been a center of alchemical study in medieval times, attracting scholars and mystics from all over Europe. These alchemists were not just early chemists, they were philosophers who sought to unlock the mysteries of nature and the cosmos. As he pieced together the clues, Lukas's theory took shape. He hypothesized that the horloge code was a puzzle left by an alchemist, a map that led to a discovery of significant importance. His days and nights were consumed by decoding efforts, each symbol a piece of an intricate puzzle that spanned the realms of astronomy, mythology, and alchemy. Lukas's breakthrough came one chilly evening in late November. He realized that the symbols corresponded to specific astronomical events, each a marker in time that aligned with the Orlich celestial dial. When he overlaid this information with historical alchemical texts, a pattern emerged, a sequence that pointed to specific locations within the city. Excited by his discovery, Lukas planned a journey through Prague to follow the trail set by the code. His first destination was the Charles Bridge, an iconic structure adorned with statues and steeped in legend. According to his interpretation, one of the bridge's statues held the next clue in the sequence. However, Lukas soon realized he was not alone in his quest. As he delved deeper into the mystery, he noticed a shadowy figure observing him from a distance. At the archives, in the square, and on the bridge, this unknown watcher seemed to be tracking his progress. Unnerved but undeterred, Lukas pressed on. His journey took him to some of Prague's most famous landmarks and some of its most hidden corners. Each location revealed a piece of the puzzle, drawing him deeper into a web of history and mystery. The quest for the Orlich secret was more than an academic pursuit for Lukas, it was a journey into the heart of Prague's identity. The city was a labyrinth of stories, where the lines between history and legend blurred. In deciphering the Orlich code, Lukas was not just uncovering a hidden past, he was unraveling the very essence of Prague. As winter set in, covering the city in a blanket of snow, Lukas found himself standing before an ancient alchemical laboratory, tucked away in a forgotten alley. The symbols had led him here, to the threshold of a discovery that promised to reveal the true nature of the Orlich code. With a mixture of excitement and apprehension, Lukas prepared to enter the laboratory. He knew that what lay within could change his understanding of history, of Prague, and of the boundary between science and myth. The mystery of the Orlich was about to be unveiled, and with it, a secret that had been hidden in the very fabric of the city for centuries. Chapter 2. The Alchemical Trail. The revelation of the code hidden within Prague's astronomical clock set Lukas on a trail that wound deep into the city's alchemical past. Prague, with its intricate blend of Gothic and Baroque architecture, had always been a city of secrets, and now Lukas found himself unraveling one of its oldest mysteries. His first clue led him to the Charles Bridge, a historic bridge adorned with statues and steeped in legend. Under the watchful gaze of saints and martyrs, Lukas examined the statue of St. John of Nepomuk, a site of many whispered secrets. Hidden within the intricate carvings of the statue's base, he found an alchemical symbol that corresponded with the code from the astronomical clock. This symbol pointed him towards the next location, the old alchemical district of Prague. Navigating the winding cobblestone streets, Lukas's journey took him to the Malostrana, or Lesser Town, an area that was once home to many alchemists of the Renaissance period. Here, tucked away in narrow lanes, were ancient workshops and laboratories that had once bubbled with the pursuit of knowledge. Some of these places had been turned into museums, while others lay forgotten, their secrets gathering dust. In one such forgotten laboratory, hidden beneath layers of history and neglect, Lukas discovered manuscripts and alchemical diagrams that shed light on the mysterious code. These diagrams spoke of the Philosopher's Stone, a legendary alchemical substance said to grant eternal life and to turn base metals into gold. The manuscripts hinted that the secret to the Philosopher's Stone was tied to the code in the astronomical clock, a secret closely guarded by a select few. As Lukas delved deeper into the alchemical mysteries, he became aware of a shadowy presence trailing his every move. This elusive figure seemed to be watching him, a silent guardian of the secrets Lukas was unearthing. He realized that his quest had attracted the attention of a secret society, the Guardians of Prague's alchemical legacy. Undeterred, Lukas followed the trail to the Strahov Monastery, renowned for its extensive library. Within its hallowed halls, he found ancient texts that contained references to the astronomical clock and its creator, Master Hanus. These texts spoke of a pact between Hanus and a secretive alchemical order, hinting that the clock was more than a timekeeping device, it was a repository of hidden knowledge. The next piece of the puzzle led Lukas to the Clementinum, a historic complex known for its astronomical observatory. Here, he discovered that the movements of the clock were aligned with certain astrological events, which were key to unlocking the code. Each celestial alignment opened a window to a location in Prague where a piece of the Philosopher's Stone secret was hidden. The trail took Lukas to various landmarks across Prague, each location revealing a fragment of the puzzle. He explored hidden chambers beneath the old town hall, deciphered inscriptions in the ancient viceroy fortress, and even ventured into the eerie ossuary of Sedlec, where he uncovered symbols that matched those on the astronomical clock. Each discovery brought Lukas closer to the truth, but also deeper into danger. The guardians of the secret, wary of his intentions, began to close in, determined to protect the knowledge that had been kept hidden for centuries. Lukas found himself in a perilous game of cat and mouse, navigating not only the physical dangers that lay in wait, but also the ethical implications of the knowledge he sought. As winter deepened, blanketing Prague in snow and turning its streets into a labyrinth of shadows and silence, Lukas arrived at the final location, a secluded garden in the heart of the city, untouched by time. Here, beneath the frost-covered ground, he unearthed an ancient artifact, a key that held the final piece of the alchemical puzzle. However, the final revelation was not what Lukas had anticipated. Instead of finding material wealth or the secret to eternal life, the artifact revealed a deeper truth. It was a crystalline prism, intricately carved with alchemical symbols and equations. When Lukas held the prism to the light, it refracted into a spectrum of colors, each beam illuminating a different part of the garden. The beams of light converged on a singular point, revealing a hidden entrance to an underground chamber beneath the garden. With a mixture of excitement and trepidation, Lukas descended into the chamber, which had remained sealed for centuries. Inside, he found an alchemist's sanctum, its walls lined with ancient tomes, flasks, and alembics. At the center of the room stood a grand astrolabe, its surfaces etched with the same symbols from the astronomical clock. As Lukas studied the astrolabe, he realized that it was a kind of celestial map, a guide to the movements of the stars and planets that the alchemists believed influenced the natural world. The true secret of the Philosopher's Stone was not a physical substance, but a profound understanding of the universe and its workings. The alchemists of old had sought not just to transform matter, but to unlock the mysteries of creation itself. The knowledge contained within the sanctum was a testament to their pursuit, a legacy of their wisdom. Lukas understood then that the secret he had uncovered was far more valuable than gold or elixirs of life. It was a treasure trove of knowledge, a link to the past that could illuminate the future. However, He also recognized the dangers of such knowledge falling into the wrong hands. The guardians, who had been watching him, emerged from the shadows, their intentions now clear. They revealed themselves as the descendants of the alchemists, sworn to protect the legacy of their forebears. They had observed Lucas's journey, gauging his intentions and his worthiness to uncover the truth. Impressed by his respect for the alchemical tradition and his understanding of its significance, they offered Lucas a choice. He could join their order, dedicating himself to preserving and studying the ancient knowledge, or he could walk away, leaving the secret buried beneath Prague. The guardians warned him that choosing to reveal the secret to the world could lead to unforeseen consequences, as not all were ready or worthy to receive such profound understanding. Lucas, standing in the dimly lit sanctum, felt the weight of history around him. His journey through Prague streets had been more than a quest for hidden treasure, it had been a pilgrimage through the annals of time, a journey that connected him to the seekers of truth who had walked these paths before him. After careful consideration, Lucas decided to join the Guardians. He realized that the knowledge he had uncovered was a sacred trust, one that required careful stewardship and wisdom. He chose to become a protector of the secret, to study and preserve the alchemical legacy for future generations who might one day be ready to embrace its truths. Lucas's journey through the labyrinth of Prague streets ended in the quiet sanctum beneath the city. He had unraveled the mystery of the astronomical clock, finding not just answers, but a deeper understanding of the quest for knowledge. The city above continued its rhythmic flow, oblivious to the ancient secrets that lay hidden in its heart, secrets that Lucas had discovered and now vowed to protect. Chapter 3. Shadows of the Past. The labyrinthine streets of Prague, with their blend of shadow and stone, had always been a sanctuary for secrets. For Lucas, each turn and alleyway now presented a puzzle steeped in history, an intricate weave of the city's alchemical and mystical past. As he delved deeper into the mystery of the astronomical clock, the weight of centuries-old secrets seemed to press against him from the ancient walls. Lucas's discoveries had taken him from the scholarly quiet of the Straub Monastery's library to the forgotten depths of alchemical workshops hidden beneath the city's bustling surface. Each location revealed fragments of a larger story, a tapestry of knowledge that the alchemists of old had striven to piece together in their quest to unravel the mysteries of the universe. As winter deepened, casting its chill over the city, Lucas's journey led him to Weisheret, the historic fort perched high above the Vltava River. Here, amidst the ruins that whispered of Prague's pagan and medieval past, Lucas found clues etched into the ancient stonework. These symbols, obscured by time, spoke of the alignment of celestial bodies and their influence on the earthly realm, a core tenet of alchemical belief. Each discovery, each piece of the puzzle that Lucas put together, brought him closer to understanding the true nature of the code within the astronomical clock. Yet, with each step forward, the sense of being watched, of being followed, grew stronger. The shadowy figure that had first appeared in the archives was now a constant presence in Lucas's periphery, a silent observer marking his progress. The realization that he was being tracked by an unknown entity added a layer of urgency to Lucas's quest. He began to take precautions, varying his routines and routes through the city. His nights were spent in restless study, poring over the ancient texts and diagrams he had gathered, all his days were a cautious dance through the streets of Prague, always mindful of the eyes upon him. Lukas's next major breakthrough occurred in an unexpected place, the old Jewish quarter, Josefov. In the ancient Jewish cemetery, where centuries-old gravestones leaned wearily against one another, Lukas discovered Hebrew inscriptions that mirrored the alchemical symbols from his research. This surprising connection between Jewish mysticism and alchemy opened a new avenue in his quest, revealing the multicultural tapestry of Prague's esoteric history. But with this revelation came new dangers. Lukas's frequent visits to the cemetery attracted unwanted attention, not just from his mysterious follower, but from others with an interest in Prague's hidden secrets. He found himself confronted one evening by a group of shadowy figures, their intentions unclear, but their interest in his research evident. Lukas managed to evade them, but the encounter left him shaken. It was a stark reminder that the secrets of the astronomical clock were more than academic curiosities, they were keys to power that many would covet. Despite the risks, Lukas pressed on. His journey led him next to the Sedlik ossuary, a chapel adorned with the bones of the dead, located in the outskirts of the city. Within this macabre setting, Lukas found symbols that matched those on the astronomical clock, arranged in a way that suggested a map or a set of directions. Following this morbid clue, Lukas ventured into the countryside surrounding Prague. His search brought him to a series of forgotten ruins, remnants of old alchemical retreats where practitioners of the art had once sought solitude for their work. In these ruins, Lukas found the most significant piece of the puzzle yet, a partial manuscript that spoke of a grand alchemical experiment, one that sought to harness the celestial energies depicted in the astronomical clock. The manuscript was incomplete, but it offered enough information for Lukas to piece together the location of the experiment's final stage, a hidden chamber beneath Prague Castle, the historic seat of Czech kings and emperors. The chamber, according to the manuscript, contained the culmination of the alchemical work, a discovery that promised to bridge the earthly and the divine. Armed with this knowledge, Lukas knew that he was on the brink of an extraordinary discovery. Yet, as he prepared to venture into the heart of Prague's power, the castle itself, he could not shake the feeling of impending danger. His every move was shadowed, and the eyes that watched him were no longer just curious, they were predatory. Lukas's quest to uncover the secret of the astronomical clock had started as an academic pursuit, a personal challenge. But it had grown into something far more significant. He found himself at the center of a web that spanned centuries, a web that connected the alchemists of old to the present, their legacy a hidden current that flowed beneath the surface of Prague's history. As he stood at the gates of Prague Castle, the manuscript tucked securely in his coat, Lukas realized that he was about to uncover a secret that had been guarded for generations. The shadows of the past loomed large, and the decisions he was about to make would not only reveal the mystery of the astronomical clock, but also determine the fate of the legacy it protected. With a deep breath, Lukas stepped forward, ready to confront the final chapter of his quest. The secret hidden within the depths of Prague Castle awaited him, a secret that held the power to illuminate or to cast into darkness the intricate tapestry of Prague's mystical past. Chapter 4. The Alchemist's Legacy. With a mixture of trepidation and determination, Lukas made his way through the dimly lit corridors beneath Prague Castle. The castle, a symbol of Czech history and power, was a labyrinth of secrets, and Lukas was about to uncover one of its oldest. The manuscript's clues led him to a hidden door, cleverly disguised within the castle's foundations. As Lukas opened the door, he was met with a rush of cool air and the scent of ancient stone. He descended a narrow staircase that spiraled downward, each step taking him deeper into the bowels of the earth. The passage ended in a large chamber, its walls lined with shelves holding dusty tomes, alchemical instruments, and strange artifacts. At the center of the chamber stood an impressive astrolabe, much like the one in the Clementinum, but larger and more intricate. The device was aligned with the astronomical clock above, its gears and symbols forming a complex astronomical map. It was here, Lukas realized, that the medieval alchemists had conducted their greatest experiment, an attempt to harness the celestial forces and unravel the mysteries of creation. The chamber was a testament to the genius of Prague's alchemists, a hidden sanctum where science, mysticism, and art converged. Lukas examined the astrolabe and the surrounding artifacts, piecing together the purpose of this secret laboratory. The alchemists had sought to create something of profound significance, something the manuscript had alluded to but never fully revealed. As he explored the chamber, Lukas found a series of cryptic notes and diagrams. They spoke of the Philosopher's Stone, but not as a means to transmute base metals into gold or a key to immortality. Instead, the Philosopher's Stone was described as a source of profound knowledge, a way to achieve harmony between the earthly and the divine, between man and the cosmos. The realization of what the alchemists had been striving for struck Lukas with awe. Their pursuit was not for personal gain, but for a deeper understanding of the universe and humanity's place within it. The astronomical clock, the astrolabe, and the chamber were all part of a grand design, a quest for enlightenment that had spanned centuries. But Lukas was not alone in his discovery. The shadows that had followed him through his journey emerged from the darkness of the chamber. They were the guardians of the secret, the descendants of the alchemists who had built this place. They had watched Lukas's progress, gauging his intentions and his worthiness to uncover the truth. The guardians explained that they had protected this knowledge for generations, ensuring it did not fall into the hands of those who would misuse it. The secret of the Philosopher's Stone was powerful and dangerous in the wrong hands. They had seen in Lukas a kindred spirit, someone who sought understanding rather than power. Faced with the magnitude of his discovery, Lukas was presented with a choice. He could join the guardians, dedicating his life to studying and protecting the ancient wisdom contained within the chamber. Or he could walk away, leaving the secret untouched, its legacy preserved. Lukas felt the weight of the decision before him. He thought of the winding streets of Prague, of the history and mysteries that had captivated him since his youth. This city, with its blend of beauty and intrigue, was a keeper of secrets, and Lukas had uncovered one of its most profound. After much contemplation, Lukas chose to join the guardians. He realized that the knowledge he had uncovered was a sacred trust, one that he could not in good conscience expose to a world that might not understand or respect its significance. He decided to dedicate himself to the study and preservation of the alchemist's legacy, to become a protector of the wisdom that had been hidden beneath Prague Castle. As he made his choice, Lukas felt a sense of peace. His journey, which had begun as a quest for knowledge, had led him to a deeper understanding of his place in the continuum of history and science. He had unraveled the mystery of the astronomical clock, finding not just answers, but a deeper connection to the past and a new purpose for his future. Lukas's days were now spent in the secret chamber, studying the ancient texts and learning the ways of the guardians. He became a bridge between the past and the present, a steward of knowledge that had once sought to illuminate the world. The streets of Prague continued to bustle above, its residents and visitors unaware of the ancient secrets that lay hidden beneath their feet. The astronomical clock continued its tireless marking of time, a silent witness to the city's history. And Lukas, once a simple researcher, had become a guardian of one of Prague's oldest mysteries, a legacy that he would protect for the rest of his days.